Great Zimbabwe is Africa's largest stone structure south of the pyramids and is one of at least 250 walled sites in Zimbabwe. Built of local granite rock, it is constructed entirely without mortar. The huge outer walls of the great enclosure are in places 15 feet thick and 35 feet high. The massive, awe-inspiring stone walls of this African lost city have long been a puzzle, giving rise to a series of controversial legends. When the first Europeans stumbled across Great Zimbabwe in the 19th century, they were unwilling to believe that Africans could have built the towering, beautifully decorated walls of the great enclosure or constructed the fine stone walling of the hilltop settlement. They preferred to believe that the city had been built by Israelites for the Queen of Sheba, or was the ruins of King Solomon's mines. But archaeologists have proved beyond doubt that Great Zimbabwe was built around 1100 CE by Africans and was the capital of a vast and thriving state for about 300 years, with trading links to the Far East and Arabia. The Kingdom of Dahomey was founded early in the 17th century in modern-day Benin. A dynasty of 13 kings ruled for a period of 200 years. Each built his own palace in the capital, Abomey. By the 19th century, the palace compound covered over 100 acres. By law, each king had to leave behind a larger kingdom than he inherited. The restored reliefs on the surviving palace walls indicate the warlike nature of this expansionist kingdom. The king's army included more than 2,000 ferocious female soldiers known as Amazons. Today, descendants of the Amazons sing and dance at ceremonial occasions. They perform for the king, who wears the royal silver nose mask of his ancestors. The kings of Dahomey grew rich from their involvement in the transatlantic slave trade. In the early 18th century, King Agaja took control of Ouidah, the principal port of the slave coast. Between the 1640s and the 1870s, an estimated 2 million slaves were shipped from this stretch of coast. Captives from this part of West Africa took with them their own religion, Vodun. Today, Ouidah is the cradle of West African Vodun, and numerous ceremonies take place throughout the year. Vodun is still the main religion of Benin and the only African religion taken to the New World that flourishes today.